Hello, happy Memorial Day. I hope all you guys are having a wonderful day, relaxing and really celebrating what this holiday is all about. But I wanted to do a surprise live video for you guys today because there's a recipe that people have been asking me about posting, and so I thought, why not just show you guys how to do it? So it's a healthy chocolate pudding. So if you guys haven't really been seeing any of my posts lately, or if you don't follow me on Instagram, I'm in the middle of a candida cleanse right now, which is zero sugar at all, even like fruit sugars or anything like that. So it's been a little tough because I'm always used to having fruit, and fruit's amazing for you, so I'm not saying you shouldn't have it, but for this particular cleanse, there's zero sugars at all. So I've had to come up with recipes to kind of satisfy that feeling of having something, you know, really good and indulgent, because it's been a lot of greens and things like that, which I love greens, but you know, every meal of the day for weeks at a time, it gets a little bit difficult. So this chocolate pudding is amazing. It's dairy-free, gluten-free, sugar-free, but it tastes so indulgent and it's so delicious. So I'm gonna show you how to make it. It's pretty easy ingredients, nothing too fancy at all. So we're starting with avocados. So this is gonna be the base for the pudding. And you don't even know avocados are in it, which is another awesome thing about this recipe, is that you get some really good healthy fats. So if you're not someone that typically likes eating just plain avocado, having it in this pudding, you won't even know it's in there. So I mean, the texture, it's just a great way to get more avocados in your diet, and those healthy fats that our body really wants. And the other good thing about this recipe is that it makes me so energized. So even though it's a dessert recipe, and most dessert recipes make people feel, you know, just like blah, or they have that sugar spike and then the crash, this dessert gives you a steady energy because of all the healthy fats in it. So we start with three ripe avocados. You wanna make sure they're ripe or they're not gonna blend up the way that you need them to. So I'm just gonna squeeze them in. I love avocados. They're so buttery, and so they give a great texture to this pudding. It really helps, you know, not having, when there's no dairy in it, it helps having avocado in to give it that really good texture. And I don't know about you, but when I was little, I loved chocolate pudding, but it's so bad for you, the kind you buy at the store. So this is a super healthy way to have chocolate pudding. Really good. Okay, so now that we have those in there, we're just gonna quickly blend them up. Get them pureed even more. A little bit, just so they're not in, you know, the big pieces. And our next ingredient is going to be some coconut milk. And you want to go for the full fat one that you buy in the can. That's what you want to get for this recipe to make it nice and creamy. So you want to do a quarter cup. I'm just going to kind of eyeball it. There we go. You don't have to be exact with this because it's not baking. So you guys all know me. I don't like to measure everything exact. Okay, next we're gonna do some cocoa powder. Plain cocoa powder. You don't want any additives in it, just plain. So make sure there's no sugar, no soy, anything like that. And for this, we're gonna do a third cup. And I am gonna measure this one, just because you don't wanna make it too overly powerful. Okay, and you just kinda drizzle it in there. Make sure it's not gonna be a cloud of cocoa powder when you turn on the food processor. You could also do this in a blender if you didn't have a food processor, that would work as well. And our next ingredient is coconut butter. This really makes this pudding fantastic. The reason being is that when this gets cold, it's kind of like coconut oil. So coconut butter is just the coconut meat that's pureed into a butter, kind of like an almond butter or a sunflower seed butter. And this gets solid when it gets cold. So this pudding recipe gets a really nice texture from this coconut butter. It's so delicious. And coconut butter has a little sweetness to it naturally. So it also helps sweeten up this pudding a little bit, which helps a lot since we're not adding any sugar to it. So we're gonna do a quarter cup of coconut butter. I'm gonna eyeball it again. So with the coconut milk and the coconut butter, they're both just very, as you can tell, this recipe is very high in fat, but they're healthy fats and it's exactly what our body needs for energy and to help burn fat. So, and it helps make this recipe really good too. Okay, so we have a quarter cup of the coconut butter and we need some vanilla. We're gonna do about 1 teaspoon of vanilla. This helps bring out that chocolate flavor. You wanna make sure you're getting pure vanilla extract, not any with some added oils. Some vanilla extracts have like sunflower oil, and even some of them have sugar added to them. I don't know why, but make sure you go for pure vanilla. And next, we're gonna do some stevia. So this is where you get the sweetness from. And stevia is just a natural, it comes from a leaf, and it doesn't spike your blood sugar at all, so it's safe to have on a candida cleanse or safe for diabetics, people that are just watching their sugar intake in general too. So this really helps bring some sweetness to this dish, or this pudding, I should say. And we're gonna do a 1/2 teaspoon. You can find this at most any grocery stores now, or you could order it online. So there's 1/2 teaspoon. Need a little bit more. Okay, so there's the stevia. And lastly, we're just gonna do a little bit of cinnamon, just to brighten it up a little bit. There we go. And that's our pudding. Now all we need to do is process it up. Might need to scrape down the sides of the bowl a little bit because it can get all over the place. So I'm gonna do that right now. Yeah, this looks so good. I've been eating this a lot lately. And it's no surprise that my skin has gotten a lot softer, and I think it's because of all the healthy fats I'm eating. Okay. That's it. I'm gonna bring it around and show it to you. You'll see the delicious texture it has. See that? Nice and thick, just like a pudding. Tastes so good. I'm going to do a little bowl of it for you guys so you can see what I top it with. Okay. So if you're making this in advance, or I should say you should make it in advance because it needs to chill in the fridge to set. That helps it get that nice pudding texture because right now it's a little loose for a pudding. So when you put it in the fridge, that coconut butter hardens up a little bit and it has a really nice texture to it when you let it chill. Okay, so we're just gonna try to make this look really pretty. Food styling on Facebook Live. Okay, so we have it. I just have this cute little cup. This is a really fun dessert too, to do almost like a dessert bar. Like if you want to have a healthy girls' night or, you know, something for your kids that's healthier than a normal dessert, like an ice cream sundae bar, you could do a healthy chocolate pudding bar and then you could have all sorts of different toppings, which I'm gonna show you some right now. Almond butter, just regular unsalted raw almond butter is what I like and what is safe for me to have right now on this diet. And I'm gonna be posting later this week a blog post about this candida cleanse I'm doing to get you guys some more info about it, just so you know what it is. Some people don't even really know what candida is and how that impacts your health. So I wrote a little blog article and I'll share it with you guys this week. So then we're gonna do some chopped walnuts, just raw walnuts, plain, nothing on them. And lastly, we're gonna do some coconut chips. And these are unsweetened coconut chips. You wanna be really careful when you're in the store buying coconut chips because a lot of them are sweetened with sugar. You think coconut's sweet enough, but really be sure to look at labels when you're buying stuff like this. I actually found these in the bulk section, surprisingly enough. I always talk about the bulk section, right? And how it's a great place to shop for things like this that you can buy in bigger quantities, and it's a lot cheaper than buying them packaged. So look for labels. They have labels on bulk items too. So that's what we have. We have some of the pudding on the bottom, some walnuts, some unsalted, unsweetened almond butter, and some unsweetened coconut flakes. I'll bring this around to show you guys now. This is what it looks like all finished. So you got the pudding on the bottom, you got the almond butter, coconut, and walnuts. How delicious does that look, you guys? I'm gonna pop this in the fridge and eat it in like 10 minutes. So good. Yum. I will post this recipe for you guys. I'll have it all written out, and that way you guys can print it out and use it a lot easier than, you know, writing it down watching this video. But I hope this was helpful for you, and it shows you that you can have a really healthy dessert without having a ton of sugar in it. So how cool is that? Especially using natural things like coconut that helps sweeten it naturally is really cool. So I hope you guys have a great rest of your holiday, and I will definitely share the link when this recipe goes up on my website. And also, I wanted to mention, last week I talked about how when I did my bloating video that I had some spots open in my one-on-one program. They are filled up. So I'm booking for June already. I'm filling up my program for June. So if you guys want help, some one-on-one help with your health, you know, getting rid of bloating, fixing your digestion, increasing your energy, you know, learning what foods really help your body to thrive, then send me a message and we can talk about doing a program together, because I want to make sure some people come to me and they want to get started right away, and then I have to end up booking them out. So I'm telling you guys now that I'm booking for June. So if you're interested in working with me, shoot me a message and we can chat. So other than that, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, rest of your holiday. I hope you guys get some relaxing in, and I hope you enjoyed this video. So I'll talk to you guys soon.